Kensington Palace has created a whole new storm of controversy surrounding Princess Kate's health after a photograph released by the royals was retracted from multiple press agencies because it had been digitally manipulated. It's being described as a breach of royal protocols and just plain bizarre, with the palace now refusing to comment.
A carefully crafted image designed to end speculation on Princess Kate's health that's now only served to fuel the conspiracy theories.
Broken a royal protocol that the pictures that are released aren't manipulated, and this is quite clearly has been manipulated. And that should beg the question, why has it been manipulated?
The first official image of Princess Kate since her abdominal surgery was released with a message: thank you for your kind wishes and continued support in the last 2 months. But within hours, the photo was being pulled from PressWise, with AP stating it appeared the source had manipulated the image.
It's fairly clear to me that this hand has been altered dramatically or been replaced completely. It's blurry, there's movement in it, there's no movement in the rest of the picture.
Scott McGale has been a photographer for 30 years. He says multiple parts have been retouched.
This person has done a pretty slapdash job.
Online sleuths have pointed to her missing wedding ring, while a forensic image analysis found further issues with the tree behind them.
Definitely there are things that you can see with the naked eye, but also things that have to be seen with software to appreciate. So definitely, I think, yeah, I'd probably give it a fail in terms of the photoshopping.
The palace has been at pains in recent weeks to paint a business-as-normal picture in Kate's absence, despite increasing speculation from the British public.
I've read some of those and they really are very unfortunate, and they're fake news. They're total fake news.
While image manipulation in our everyday lives is nothing new, the risks surrounding it are only growing. With an election in the US this year, the Global Economic Forum puts misinformation and disinformation as the biggest short-term risk to humanity.
If people are playing with the truth, they're playing with our credibility, with our perceptions of reality. That's really dangerous territory to be in.
Ursula Hager for 10 News First.
OK, now to our Europe correspondent, John-Paul Gonzo, who joins us live from outside Buckingham Palace. John-Paul, this has been quite the remarkable turn of events for the royal family.
Sandra, extraordinary, astonishing, damaging, just some of the words being used by royal commentators to describe this PR disaster. This is fundamentally an issue about truth, and if health updates provided by Kensington Palace and Buckingham Palace, for that matter, can actually be believed. It is clear something is amiss with that photograph, and as Ursula touched on in her report there, the entire point of its release was to try and quell rampant rumours about Princess Kate's whereabouts and well-being. What started as fringe conspiracy theories about her health and her recovery has now exploded into the mainstream, and Kensington Palace so far is still yet to confirm why this photo was manipulated or even release a statement regarding it. In the coming hours here, the royal family will be attending a Commonwealth Day service at Westminster Abbey. Kate obviously won't be there, neither will the King. He has recorded a special video message as he undergoes cancer treatment. Prince William is set to be there, but whether or not he actually attends remains to be seen. Last month, he cancelled a crucial engagement at the last minute due to an undisclosed personal matter. Sandra, that service is due to get underway here in the coming hours.
Well, no soon enough. All right, John-Paul, thank you.